forward scratch is the first scratch where we combine using the crossfader at the same time as using our record control hand. It sounds like this. So this technique is a combination of using the drop, which you learned in a previous video, together with opening and closing the crossfader. It does require some coordination, so don't worry if it feels awkward to start with. It does take a little while to get used to. But with practice, you're definitely going to see your technique improve and you'll make good progress. I'm going to demonstrate this very slowly with exaggerated and deliberate hand movements so you can see exactly what is happening. So let's break it down. Find the beginning of your scratch sample. I'm using R, and my record is marked at 12 o'clock. Quick tip here is to slow down the speed of your record all the way to minus 8, and this will play the sample more slowly. So this means you've got more time to really practice the technique. Once you find the start of your scratch sample, you're going to open the crossfader. So if you're scratching with your crossfader reversed or hamster like me, you open it this way. But if you're scratching with your crossfader in regular, then you're going to open it this way. Hold the crossfader in whatever way feels comfortable for you. You can pinch it between your finger and your thumb. Some people use two fingers and a thumb. The way that I like to do it is to have my hand in a kind of C position, and then I just tap and kind of pivot my wrist. So just experiment and do what feels right for you. There's no kind of right and wrong, it's just whatever's most efficient and feels comfortable. Once the crossfader's open, you're going to let the record play forwards just like you did with the drop. Then when you get to the end of the sample, so when this sticker's round about here, you're going to close the crossfader and immediately put your hand on the record to stop it. So let me demo this part to you first of all. So you can see I've closed the crossfader and put my hand on the record to stop it. So the next step is to pull the record back to the starting position while the crossfader is closed. And because the crossfader is closed, it cuts off the reverse sound. For this scratch, we only want to hear the forward sound of the record. So let's try that again. Open the crossfader. I've played the record forward, closed the crossfader, and now I need to rewind it. To start with, it's going to feel a little bit strange, and I'm doing this in a very kind of slow and exaggerated way. Once you've built up some speed, you're kind of going to release the crossfader at the same time as you play the record, like this. So once you've practiced it a few times and you can do it slowly, the next step is to increase the speed. You can also try using different sounds. One of the samples I like to use is the Ahhh Yeah sample. So you can play the whole sample like this.
Ahhh Yeah! Ahhh Yeah! Ahhh Yeah!
Or you can play just the start of the sample, which says Ah. So use a variety of samples and have some fun experimenting. Now let's hear how it sounds over a beat.
Ah!
So now we've broken it down and heard how it sounds over a beat, let's try practicing it together. Don't worry about getting it perfect or if you mess up, there's really no such thing as messing up, only learning and progress. Just keep practicing. I'll do the forward scratch for 4 bars, then leave a gap for you to scratch for 4 bars. Let's go! That wraps up the forward scratch. Hopefully, you're starting to see how the fader can be used together with your record hand to create different sounds. So keep practicing this scratch, and as with the drop, concentrate on getting your scratches in time with the beat and build up your fader and record hand coordination. Happy scratching!